Tonight's top story, though, on a controversial national group targets tri-state students. We're talking about the group that came to the funerals of troops with messages of hate. Today, a few members showed up at Oak Hills High School.
And News 5's Brian Hamrick is covering the reaction, the impact, and the overwhelming show of support from the community live from Green Township. Brian?
Yeah, Laura. Well, afternoon classes had to be canceled here at Oak Hills High School. Extra police details had to be called in, all for a handful of radical protesters who were met by a couple of hundred of the home crowd.
It's both early dismissal and dismissive.
My son texted me this morning telling me he's getting out early.
As Oak Hills High School prepares for a protest.
We got the voicemails from Oak Hills that they were going to let out early, and I just think it's a good idea.
What's up, dude?
In order to avoid as much conflict as possible, the school let students out of class almost 2 hours ahead of the scheduled protest, then asked students and parents to stay away from it. That request drew mixed emotions.
They're using their First Amendment rights. I don't see why Oak Hill says we can't use ours.
Because the counter-protest causes more, you know, conflict and reason for more, you know, they get more rise out of it.
News 5 is electing not to give protesters a platform to spread their message, but when the group arrived, they were out protested. Just four of the Westboro Baptist Church showed up, far less even than the number of police called out, and outnumbered at least 50-1 by counter protesters.
They've already had enough attention. Now we need to take a stand and show our voice as well.
And I'm not going to stop until I see them go out and leave.
In about 20 minutes, the protesters were gone. And so was everyone else, leaving behind not much more than a loud civics lesson.
And even administrators here at Oak Hills High School didn't know why they were targeted, but we do know that the protesters were here for events in both Ohio State and at Miami University. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, News 5.